this is the new Apple, or at least that's what Tim Cook wants you to believe after WWDC 2025. Forget iOS 19, macOS 15. Apple just pressed the reset button. A brand new naming scheme, a brand new design language, and a stack of updates that finally makes it all feel different. So let's break down the 10 biggest things Apple just dropped rapid fire. And if you want to see the deep dives on each of these platforms individually, be sure you subscribe so you don't miss those. Now, here's what actually matters. First, the name reset. It's the obvious. Every OS gets a new number. iOS 26, macOS 26. No more what version are we on confusion. Apple wants you to feel like you're stepping into something fresh. And it makes sense. So now iOS, macOS, watchOS, visionOS, tvOS, and iPadOS are all on version 26. But a new name would feel empty if there wasn't also something new to look at. Enter the showstopper, liquid glass design. This is Apple's biggest design overhaul in 12 years since iOS 7. Think soft transparency and translucency everywhere. Menus and apps float, layer, and blend. It's got a clean, futuristic look without being over the top and confusing. And for the first time in years, every Apple device actually looks related, giving us consistency across the board. But design is only skin deep unless it changes the way you use your core apps. Which brings us to the fact that Apple went all in with this redesign. The camera app now has a totally overhauled interface with less clutter, easier controls, and faster access to key features. Safari's new fluid tab bars shrink, expand, and morph depending on context, so it feels less like a browser and more like a full screen experience. In the phone app, Apple cleaned it up. This one is optional and maybe jarring for some at first. Favorites, recents, voicemail, those are all now in one smart consolidated view with glanceable info and swipe hack. But Apple didn't just stop at these apps. iPad power users finally get what they've been asking for years. Because yes, iPadOS 26 introduces true multitasking with resizable, movable windows. You're no longer locked to split view or slide over. You can stack, overlap, and move windows freely just like you can on a Mac. There's even a new Mac-style menu bar that shows up when you hover with a mouse or trackpad at the top of the screen, plus better keyboard shortcuts and window snapping. Apple is clearly aiming to bridge the gap between iPad and Mac without actually merging them. This makes the iPad feel more capable, more flexible, and honestly, for the first time, like a real, genuine laptop alternative. Still, messaging is where a lot of us live every day, so Apple addressed that too. We're getting a surprisingly fun set of upgrades to messages. For the first time, you can fully customize your chat backgrounds so your family group text doesn't have to look like your fantasy football thread. And if you're not the artsy type, Apple Intelligence steps in with AI-generated backgrounds that match the vibe of your group. You can also run interactive polls directly in group chats, making it easier to plan hangouts, vote on dinner spots, or just settle debates. Oh, and group chats will also now have typing indicators. It's small stuff, but it's the kind of polish that makes everyday use feel more personal and modern. And these little things add up, especially when AI steps in. Visual intelligence now has the ability to understand what's on your screen in real time. You take a screenshot and it'll instantly scan, identify, and pull out relevant details that you asked for. So let's say you're reading a long email about a meeting. You can ask visual intelligence to extract the date and location and create a calendar event. Or if you're looking at a screenshot of a product, it can recognize it, pull up reviews, and even suggest where to buy the product. But desktop users, don't think you've been left out, because Apple's making macOS smarter too. Spotlight just became a real power tool in macOS 26, which is officially named macOS Tahoe. Spotlight is faster, smarter, and way more context aware. You can now filter results by file type, recency, or even the app that created them. Plus, it ties in tightly with Apple Intelligence. You can send emails, create notes, play media, send messages, run shortcuts, all without leaving the Spotlight interface. Basically, Command Center meets an AI assistant. Less time digging, more time doing, and it looks and feels cleaner thanks to that new liquid glass design that we talked about. But let's zoom out literally. Apple's also upgrading the spatial computing game. So Vision Pro users, spatial widgets are finally here. You can now pin a weather widget to your wall, giving you a virtual window, or float your calendar in your workspace, or have reminders subtly anchored in your environment throughout the day. These are fully interactive elements that live in your space, so you can glance, tap, and manipulate them with gestures, all while staying in your flow. It's Apple's most natural integration of utility into mixed reality to date. Widgets done the Apple way, but reimagined for 3D space. And even cooler, the Vision Pro remembers where you place your windows and widgets even after a reboot. What if you want more than just widgets? What if you want real immersive control? This one's for the gamers, and I think personally for the Apple Vision Pro, it is a big deal. In visionOS 26, the Vision Pro will support PlayStation VR 2 controllers, unlocking a new tier of immersive precision gameplay inside Apple's Spatial device. Now, these are some of the best motion track controllers on the market. It's adaptive triggers and haptics that rival pretty much anything else out there. Apple hasn't fully detailed which games specifically will support it. I assume it's just up to the developer, but the hardware groundwork is now in place. For a platform that's been way more productivity than play, this is a massive shift toward real mixed reality gaming on the Vision Pro. Apple's making another big move to tie all your games together. The Games app is a new full-blown social gaming hub. You can see what your friends are playing in real time, track leaderboard standings, compare achievements, and launch into multiplayer sessions directly from within the app. Think of it as Game Center 2.0, but actually useful. It pulls in all your Apple Arcade titles and App Store games, and on the Mac, all the other games you have installed on your system. After years of treating gaming like afterthought and some false stop starts, Apple's finally building the kind of ecosystem that might, maybe, keep up with the serious player. And it's all stored in one place. That's Apple's new playbook. A total reset for the design and experience across their operating systems, focus on refining the day-to-day usability, and a few long overdue upgrades that push their devices forward in meaningful ways. Any questions, drop them down below. And again, stay tuned for those deep dives on each individual operating system. Thanks for watching as always, guys. I appreciate your support. I'm Andrew Wearers, and I'll catch you in the next video.